My beauty secrets. Well, I actually like to, I brush my lips with my toothbrush every morning, and it like every day brings more like color, natural color to them, and sort of makes them fuller and stuff. And then eye cream, I put eye cream on all day long. I don't know, I mean, I can't say specifically for this fall, but the thing I love about fall and fashion is it's the time to be dramatic, and when luxury is really brought in. So it's the time where, for me, in my kind of beauty ideas, it's when, you know, you wear the really rich reds or like, you know, like a beautiful gold. You know, and everything's sort of about texture and mood and color, and that's really something I really love about fall fashion. I like a lot of different things, but I guess I like things that are, you know, a very specific, a very distinct shape, and pretty, and dramatic, and usually short, because I'm short.
For CK Calvin Klein for Spring 08, I wanted to do something very vibrant, very colorful, very minimal, very Calvin, but with a slight organic feel to it. The fabrics I'm using are all silk with some cotton, but I twisted some nylon in amongst the fabric to give a very kind of minimalist modern sheen and shimmer to the fabric. The colors I've used a range of whites, cocoon gray, ash, but really injected it with like these makeup hot bright colors like hot lava, fuchsia, and bright turquoise. And actually you can find those colors in our makeup line, in our new CK Beauty line that we're launching for spring 2008. I've used a lot of color this season because I just felt that it was the right thing. I was quite inspired by nature and organic forms and organic fabrics, but I wanted to bring out the color of nature, keeping it modern and keeping it exciting, and using the vibrancy and illuminescence of nature. The silhouettes that I'm working on are either very away from the body, voluminous cocoon shapes, soft, or actually very tight and very close to the body. So it's this counterbalance of the two together. And actually I'm feeling very much for short, and I wanted to have a lot of long legs, very, very short, sexy, bold, and graphic. With the collection, I've used the accessories with a lot of texture. I've used classic Calvin pythons, crocodile skins. It's a mixture of texture, and I've used very, very flat sandals or extremely high sandals. The bags are very organic shaped, very round, slouchy, cool hobos, are also very angular and architectural, like big envelope clutches. I was really influenced by the beauty line in my collection by using all the color of the line. And what's really important is this fusion of beauty and fashion together. They're intrinsically linked. They're both seductive tools, they're both sexy, and they really, really change a woman's personality. So I think beauty and fashion are the perfect combination. I think both influence each other. This season, actually, I was influenced by beauty. And last fall in my collection, I was influenced by the clothing first, and then beauty came secondary. But I think that they're both linked. As I've said, they're both seductive tools, and they both really give over a mood of the season. What I think is really sexy about beauty, what I like, is I love the lip. I think that the lip is a very sexual, seductive tool. I think it's something that I find just extremely sexy, and one can use it and have a very natural color on it and make one statement, or one can use it in a very bright way and make another statement on different occasions. What's great about the new beauty line is there's a lot of must-haves in the line. We have great signature foundations, bases that every woman will want to wear, but we also have the hot thing of the season. Just like in fashion, whether it's the metallic bag of the season, the python bag of the season, we've got the right eyeshadow for that season. And that's what I love about our beauty line. It's so linked to fashion. Mark and I work together right at the beginning of the season. He's really involved when I'm finished with my colors and fabrics. We sit down, I brief him on the mood of the season, what I'm feeling, whether it's romantic, sexy, where it's slightly aggressive, whether it's very, very minimal, or whether it has a slight organic minimalism feeling. We work very much right at the beginning. So I show him all my colors, all my inspiration. Then we have another meeting, we talk about fabrics, and fabrics for me are very, very important. I love working with the two-dimensional to the three-dimensional. And so with Mark, with fabrics, it's what I'm feeling, whether I'm feeling something soft like super cashmere, peach finishes, and taking that, interpreting it that in the touch and texture of the makeup, or whether I'm feeling that the fabrics have a nylon yarn running through them, or they have sequins and have shimmer. How do we translate that into makeup? How do we create that iridescent on the face that complements the clothes? Then we work together on the colors, the textures, the fabrics, and then Mark goes away and reinterprets my fashion ideas, and then we collaborate again going forward until we finally find the face of the season, whether it's the eye of the season, the lip of the season, and the cheek of the season, and what that relation is to the clothing. I always describe the CK Calvin Klein woman as an individual. She's sexy, she's confident, she's an individual, and she likes experimenting both in her clothing and in her beauty. The ultimate fashion beauty is stay true to who you are, but with a little bit of experimentation on a seasonal basis.
The new CK Beauty line is directly linked to CK fashion. It's a multicultural consumer, and I'm really excited. It's a broad line of foundations, concealers, blush, eyeshadow, lipsticks, lip glosses, pencils, eyebrow pencils, nail varnish. It's really amazing. I'm really excited to be part of it. What sets it apart is it's got amazing sleek packaging by Fabian Barone, who's worked on the packaging. It's gorgeous, and I think it's a really like desirable thing. When you see it, you want to pick it up, you want to own it, you want to touch it. So that's the first thing that really sets it apart from other brands. I also think that when you feel the consistency of the products, they're really luxurious, they're high quality. I think it's really easy for the consumer to use the products. So it's quite an interesting brand of makeup. The CK Beauty line is set apart because, first of all, the sleek packaging is a really amazing, seductive package. So when you see it, you want to pick it up, you want to touch it. It's designed by Fabian Barone, and I'm really excited about it. It looks great. The product is really luxurious. When you feel the products, the shadows are really satiny, the foundations are amazing, they're creamy, they're easy to use. I think that the consumer is going to have a really great time playing with them. They're consumer friendly, they're easy. You put it on, you see the result, it's a great product. And I think it's a really well-priced product. I think it's really great, the price is amazing. My inspiration for spring 2008 was color, basically. I fell in love with the idea of color again. I think it all originated from the beginning when I started to put like lip on again. Like I did seasons and seasons, beige lip, no lip, all these options of not having a lip. And then all of a sudden I got inspired to do red again and fuchsia again. And from that, it inspired me to go more. So I started to play with color. So I think that the inspiration comes directly from the new idea about the revamping of a lipstick. And then it broadened into color. And it's old tools. Then I started to think about eyeliner and all these old ideas about makeup, like lipstick, eyeliner. And so I think that major trends are eyeliner, lipstick, and color. I really enjoy working with Kevin Carrigan because he's a major talent and he never ceases to amaze me. He sends me beautiful pieces of fabric to look at all the time, and he tells me about technology and the colors and his inspiration. He shows me photographs. And I think that you need those inspirations to come off what he's thinking about fashion-wise. And then when you see the result, like when you see a dress or a garment made from this like new technology or new fabric, you get inspired. He showed me this little piece of fabric with a thread in it that looked to me like Lorax, and he told me that it was actually some kind of plastic thread. And then I started to think about how do I translate that plastic thing to a face? And I started to think about like a shine that's more plasticky than metallic and things like that. So without the fashion, you don't have a new beauty concept. And I think that you also need the face to embellish the fashion, to ID the woman, to make her part of a gang, say, to tell her like, this is who she is. So without fashion, you don't have beauty, and without beauty, you don't have fashion. So it needs to be seamless. It has to hand in hand with each other. And I think that when you work with really talented people, you find that they inspire you all the time, just through conversation, you know, through like the piece of fabric that he shows you, and it teaches you something new about your craft all the time.